We've been looking a little bit at some of the misunderstood texts or verses that we find in the New Testament. So on today's meditation, we're going to look at a verse in Matthew's Gospel, chapter 24, verses 38 to 42. I'll just read it. For as in the days before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered the ark, and did not know until the flood came and took them all away. So also will the coming of the Son of Man be. Two men will be in the field, one will be taken away and the other left. And two women will be grinding at the mill, one will be taken and the other left. Watch therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. And this text has been misused by those who are opposing the doctrine of the pre-tribulation rapture of the saints. Now, let me say right up front that these verses that I've read are not describing the rapture, the pre-tribulation rapture of the saints. The verses that I've read are describing the judgment of the living at the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ in glory. It's not about the rapture, it's about the judgment of the living. Now, those who oppose the doctrine of the pre-tribulation rapture of the saints, two of their arguments, or they have lots of arguments, and two of them are that the rapture is semi-based on a fictional series called The Left Behind. Now, they can't really believe that, but it often comes up, oh, The Left Behind series, okay? The doctrine of the rapture, the pre-tribulational rapture, came out long before The Left Behind series. I've never read The Left Behind series, and I never will read The Left Behind series. I got my doctrine on the hope, the imminent return of the Lord Jesus Christ from the Scriptures. And, of course, I've studied the writings of many who have gone before, who have believed it as well. But I believe it's the doctrine of Paul. We get it in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, 2 Thessalonians 2, and the John in his Gospel, chapter 14, speaks of it, that the Lord Jesus was going to prepare a place for us, and he would go away, and he would come again and receive us unto himself there. Where he is, we would be also. And we can directly relate that to 1 Thessalonians 4, we'll meet the Lord in the air, and so we shall ever be with the Lord. My thought is not to go into all the details of this, but just to point out that this particular verse, or these verses, are not describing that. Okay? And so those who oppose the doctrine of the rapture, as I said, they use the Left Behind series, and they also use these verses. They say that those who believe in the rapture base the idea of left behind upon these verses, and that those that are taken here are taken in the rapture. We do not teach that, okay? I've never met a serious student of the Scripture who believed in the pre-tribulational rapture who taught that. I assumed that this was an argument used only by those who oppose the rapture. It's sort of like a straw man, that we believe that these verses are speaking of the rapture, and so they sort of mock it and so on, because obviously the passages have having to do with judgment at the Lord's return in glory. But lo and behold, I was on Twitter the other day, and I saw some Christians who believed in the rapture, and they used these verses to prove the pre-tribulational rapture. So I said, okay, this is one of the misunderstood texts of the New Testament. What's the Lord Jesus is describing here is at his coming in glory, there will be a discriminating judgment. We have a discriminating judgment. You know, in the great flood of Noah, and the Lord uses us somewhat as a type here in describing it as a picture of the days in which the coming of the Son of Man will be like. Everyone was swept away in judgment except for Noah and his family. But what's described here, there will be a discriminating judgment. Some will be taken in judgment, others will be spared to enter the millennial kingdom. And this is just what we have in chapter 25, when you see the Son of Man judge the nations. It's the judgment of the living nations. We get in this verse 31 of chapter 25, when the Son of Man comes in his glory, and all the holy angels with him, then he will sit on the throne of his glory. All nations will be gathered before him, and he will separate them one from another, as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. And he will set the sheep on his right hand and the goats on his left. And so the sheep enter into his glory, into the kingdom, and the goats are cast away into judgment, into fire. This judgment of the living, this discriminating judgment, is what we have here, is not the great white throne judgment, or the judgment of the dead. That occurs 1,000 years after this. So the Bible speaks of a judgment of the living and a judgment of the dead. If you want to look up the verses that have to do, or actually mention, the judgment of the living, we find it Acts chapter 10, verse 42, 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 1, and 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 5, all speak of the judgment of the living and the dead. So there's two judgments, a judgment of the living and the judgment of the dead. And the judgment of the living falls into into the day of the Lord, in the term we call the day of the Lord, or the scripture calls the day of the Lord, but at the beginning of the day of the Lord. So perhaps the second half of the Great Tribulation will start the judgment of the living, but then we get the final judgment here of the judgment of the living, of the living nations. And again, I say, this is not the great white throne judgment that we have in chapter 25 or chapter 24. There's no dead and raised people here. They're the living nations. Okay, no one has died and been raised and standing before that throne. That's another 1,000 years after this. We get that in Revelation chapter 20. And I know there are those who spiritualize that 1,000 years and so on, but we want to read the scriptures as they are, and read and understand them as they're written. So we have here the judgment of the living, of the nations, and certain ones are taken in judgment at the Lord's coming in glory, and others are spared to enter into the glorious millennial kingdom of Christ. Another point I probably should bring out here is the fact that the Lord Jesus here is not speaking to Christians as such. He's speaking to the disciples and those with the disciples. He's speaking to them as Jews. He's speaking about the nation of Israel here. There's nothing to do with the church here. The church will be taken out before this scene that occurs in this chapter and in chapter 25. When the Lord appears in glory, we will appear with him. We get that in Colossians chapter 3. The head must have his body with him. The head will not be revealed in glory without his body. He will come for us first to take us to be with himself. We see it in Revelation 19 when the Lord is revealed from heaven in glory. There were armies with him. Some will be angels, others will be the church. Will be revealed in glory with him. Check it out, Colossians chapter 3, verse 1 to 4. And also 1 Thessalonians 4, I think it's around verse 13, that when Jesus comes, he will bring the saints with him. It's clear that the coming of the Lord is first for the church, and then after the Great Tribulation, he comes with the church. And so the church is not found in this scene. What's described in chapter 24, the abomination of desolation, the signs which appear in the heavens, the judgment of the living, specifically in this chapter, deals with the Jewish people. The judgment of the living also takes in, as we see, the nations as well. It's not the church, it's not believers, the nations, Israel and the nations. So if you want to contend for the doctrine of the rapture, please don't use these verses. The people here are not taken in the rapture, and those left behind are left behind on the earth for the judgment at the coming of the Lord. It's just the opposite. Those who are taken here are taken in judgment, and those who are left behind are spared to be blessed. So let's get our scriptures correct and our doctrine correct. The hope of the believer is the coming of the Lord for the church. But in this passage, It is not the coming of the Lord for the church. It is the coming of the Lord to judge the living. The dead will be judged later, as I said. Well, the Lord may bless you today, and get into the Word, and read the Word in its context, and understand what the Word says usually is what it means. And may the Lord encourage you today. Amen.